tomato parathas are very simple and tasty parathas, and they are different from the usual parathas that we make. Now these parathas are very wholesome and also make for a good lunchbox recipe. So let's get started and check out the recipe. First, I'm going to mix the dough for the parathas. For this, take 2 cups of wheat flour. To this, add 1/2 teaspoon of carom seeds, 1/2 teaspoon salt, 4 enough water and mix the dough. Knead the dough for 10 minutes till we get a nice soft pallidly dough, and then rest it till we make the filling for the parathas. Now I'm going to make the filling for the parathas. Add 1 tablespoon of oil. To this, add 5 cloves of garlic finely chopped. Next, add 1 large onion finely chopped. Next, add 2 green chilies chopped. Once the onions are transparent, add 2 medium-sized tomatoes finely chopped. Next, add 1 teaspoon of salt. Now you can adjust the salt according to taste. 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon cumin powder, 1 teaspoon coriander powder, 2 teaspoons Kashmiri red chili powder. Cook the masala till it's nice and dry and all the raw smell is gone. Before turning off the stove, add freshly chopped coriander leaves. Mix it well. Cool the mixture, and then I'm going to make the parathas. Divide the dough into even sized dough balls. Next, I'm going to make the parathas. For this, dust the rolling surface with some flour. Place the dough ball. Gently roll it out. Make sure the sides are a bit thinner than the center. I'm going to place the filling in the center. Seal it. Make sure it's completely sealed before you start rolling it out. Dust with a little flour. Heat the tawa, place the paratha, cook on one side, flip it over to the other. Once it's half cooked on both sides, add a little ghee. Keep the flame on medium and cook the paratha so it's cooked through evenly. Cook the paratha until it's completely done. Remove from the pan, serve it hot. Next, I'm going to make a quick spice curd to go with the parathas. For this, I've taken 200 ml of curd. Whisk the curd till it's nice and creamy. To this, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of chaat masala powder, 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder. Add a pinch of salt and finely chopped coriander leaves. Mix it well and serve it chilled with the hot parathas. So as you can see, these parathas are so quick and easy to make, and in case you don't have any vegetables for a stuffed paratha, these are very simple. You can try them, they're very delicious, and you can also enjoy them with some curd and salad by the side. You can get a copy of our first edition of the Home Cooking book on Amazon and 21 Frames.